Hi, I am Dr. Ada Başgül Martin. In this video, I will talk all about pituitary gland, also known as hypophysis, anatomy, physiology, and microscopy. Pituitary gland is located within a bony structure called cella thoracica of the sphenoid bone at the base of the brain. It hangs from the hypothalamus with a tiny stalk. This stalk formed by the blood vessels and axons of the nerves that the cell body found in hypothalamus. And pituitary gland has two lobes. Front portion of the lobe we call anterior lobe or adenohypophysis, and back portion we will call posterior lobe or neurohypophysis. 80% of the hypophysis is known as the anterior lobe. Between them, we have a tiny, tiny portion we will call intermediate lobe. Pituitary gland secretes hormones into bloodstream and also called the master gland of the endocrine system because it controls many other glands in the body. However, it takes the order from the hypothalamus. The hypothalamus sends signals through their releasing hormones to pituitary gland, telling it just how much hormones are needed to send to the other glands. Then the pituitary secretes hormones that signal to the glands how much hormones they need to secrete. And in this picture, you can see the pituitary gland labeled with the yellow sticker, and you can see the stalk attached to this triangle zone in the brain we call hypothalamus. Anterior lobe of the pituitary produces and releases or secretes six main hormones: growth hormone, thyroid stimulating hormone, adrenocorticotropic hormone, prolactin, follicle stimulating hormone, and luteinizing hormone. FSH and LH together called gonadotropes. The posterior portion of the pituitary called neurohypophysis because there is nerve endings in the posterior portion. There is no hormone production, there is no glands to produce hormones. However, and it's secreted two hormones already produced in hypothalamus in this section. So posterior pituitary secretes, not produce, two hormones, antidiuretic hormone ADH and oxytocin. And in the middle part, tiny middle part, we will call intermediary portion secretes melanocyte stimulating hormone. We send anterior pituitary gland produce and secrete. Posterior pituitary gland only secretes. So let's talk about the anterior pituitary gland hormones. First of all, growth hormone. Growth hormone regulates growth and physical development and has important effects on body shape by stimulating the muscle formation and bone and reduce the fat tissue. When we look at the thyroid stimulating hormone, stimulates the thyroid gland. TSH, thyroid stimulating hormone, released from anterior pituitary and has an effect on the thyroid gland. So thyroid gland can produce the thyroid hormone T3 and T4. And so they can have an effect on metabolism. And anterior pituitary gland release adrenocorticotrope hormone, ACTH, also known corticotropin, stimulates the adrenal gland cortex to produce the cortisol. Follicle stimulating hormone has effect on the gonads. For male, this is testes. For female, this is ovary. So it affects the ovary and helps the maturation of the egg in female and helps the production of sperm in testes. And luteinizing hormone, another gonadotropin, and has an effect on ovary and testes and stimulate in ovary production of estrogen and progesterone sex hormones, and for testes helps to produce testosterone. Also, prolactin released from the anterior pituitary gland and stimulates the mammary glands of the breast to produce milk. Notice the pituitary gland also secretes endorphins, which helps controlling the pain. Posterior pituitary gland only secretes the hormones already produced in hypothalamus. These hormones are antidiuretic hormone, ADH, which regulates the amount of the water excreted by the kidneys. And it is important for maintaining water balance. And second one is oxytocin, which causes the uterus to contract during childbirth and immediately after delivery to prevent excessive bleeding. Oxytocin also stimulates the contraction of the milk ducts in the breast, which move milk to the nipple in lactating women. Pituitary gland is derived from two embryologically distinct tissues, neural and glandular tissue. That's why anterior pituitary, called adenohypophysis, is composed predominantly of cells that secrete hormones. As you see here, you can see the glands. It's populated with the glands. When you look at the posterior lobe, as you see here, we call pars nervosa or neurohypophysis, is not a separate organ, but an extension of the hypothalamus. And you see here, it has the same structure, right? Same texture. Okay, because it has axons of hypothalamic neurons, which extends downward as a large bundle behind the anterior pituitary. It also forms the, as you notice, pituitary stalk. Between anterior and posterior lobes, we have a narrow region called intermediary section or pars intermedia, which also its embryologic origin is in the Rathke's pouch. The pars intermedia is poorly developed in humans, and glandular part mostly considered as part of the anterior lobe. Under the microscope, you should be able to recognize this tissue sample taken from the pituitary gland. And if you see glandular structure and it's pointing, you should say this is adenohypophysis or anterior lobe, this is posterior lobe, and this is stalk and hypothalamus. That's all you need to say for my classes. Although you were not asked to identify what type of cells from the glandular tissue of anterior pituitary gland, but it is good to know that there are three different groups of cells called acidophils and produce polypeptide hormones. They stain the pink reddish and they produce growth hormone and prolactin. And another type of cell, basophils, produce glycoprotein, that means sugar and protein hormones, thyroid stimulating hormone, LH, FSH, and ACTH. And those both acidophils and basophils called chromophils because they hold the stain, they stain well. But chromophobes, the third group, they are not hold the stain, and they stain poorly. That's why we call chromophobes, phobia, right? Fear. Some of them inactive, they already lost their granules, and some are act as a stem cells. I hope you learned and enjoy it. Please make sure to click the like and subscribe button below.